Good morning. Let's take our seats if you can. Welcome to those that are watching online. Welcome to those that are in the house. Welcome to this Easter Sunday morning. In more traditional churches, the minister shouts, "He is risen," and you all shout, "He is risen indeed." So shall we give that a go? Okay. Let's be a bit traditional this morning. Amen. He is risen. I think you can do better than that. He is risen.
He is risen.
He definitely is risen. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Okay, we're going to have a great week. We're going to have a great service this morning. Crocheting group is on Wednesday. See Tracy if you want to be part of that. Alpha starts this week on Tuesday. That's great as well, isn't it? We're going to have a wonderful time this worshiping the Lord this morning. So stand with me. We'll pray, and then we're going to worship the Lord together. Father, we just want to thank you this Easter Sunday morning that, Father, that we're in the presence of the living God. That, Father, Lord Jesus, that we stand, Lord Jesus, in your presence, and we know that you're alive and alive forevermore. So I just pray that your anointing would flow in this building this morning. And we just sense your presence in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thanks, Steve.
Good morning, everyone. Morning. Happy Easter. Happy Resurrection Day. Amen. Oh, we've got to be a bit with it more than that. Let's praise the Lord together. Let me just read a few verses. On the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the tomb rolled away from the tomb. But when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen." Amen. He is not in a tomb. You can go to Jerusalem, but you will not find his tomb. Because he's not there. Amen. He is risen. Hallelujah. What a wonderful truth that we have this day. A fantastic day. It's a happy day when Jesus washed my sins away. Hallelujah. Let's just worship him. The greatest day in history.
Day in history, death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. He's alive. Stand in that place, free at last, meeting face to face. I am yours, Jesus, you are mine. Endless joy, perfect peace, earthly pain finally will cease. Celebrate, Jesus is alive. He's alive. And
Fix my choice on thee, my Saviour and my God. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. What a wonderful day. What a wonderful day. Hallelujah. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King.
reveal the kingdom coming and to reconcile the lost, to redeem the whole creation who did not despise the cross. For even in your suffering, you saw it to the other side, knowing this was for salvation, Jesus, for our sake you died. Let's praise his name, praise the Father, praise the Son, till that stone was moved for good, for the Lamb had conquered death, and the dead rose from their tomb, and the angels stood in awe, for the souls of all who come to the Father are restored, and the Church of Christ was born, and the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of old shall not kneel, shall not faint. By his blood and in his name, in his freedom I am free. For the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me. Let's praise his name. Risen,
conquering son. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. How great the chasm that lay between us, how high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness your loving kindness tore through the shadow of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Who could imagine so great a mercy? Why I could fathom such boundless grace? The God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross has spoken, I am forgiven. King of glory calls me his own. Beautiful Savior, I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Its grip on me, you have broken. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ.
Bless your name.
My living hope. Bless the Lord. This morning, no longer in a tomb, but risen, exalted, glorified in the heaven. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Stars they went, the morning sun was dead, the Savior of the world was fallen, his body on the cross, his blood put out for us, the weight of every curse upon him. Final breath he gave as heaven looked away. The Son of God was laid in darkness, a battle in the grave, the war on death was waged, the power of hell. Perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeated. Forever he is glorified. Forever he is lifted high.
Forever he is glory.
is alive. The King is among us today. In a few weeks' time, our King will walk into church and they will anoint him as King over this country. But I want to tell you, there's one that's sitting on the throne who is anointed King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and his name is Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 We sing hallelujah. Ascended and he's glorified. Praise the Lord. Take your seats. Amen. Bless the Lord. Thank you guys for leading us in worship this morning. I want to start off with a story. Some of you are going to say we've heard them all before. You probably have heard this one before. This is not a joke. This is a true story. If you go onto the internet, you can believe everything you read on Google. You can believe absolutely everything. There is a story called Checkmate. Let me read it to you. There's a story of two men in a museum who were looking at a painting of a chess game. One character in the painting looked like a man and the other looked very much like the devil. The man was down to his last piece. The title over the painting was Checkmate. One of the two men looking at the painting was an international chess champion. Something about the painting intrigued him. He began to study it. He grew engrossed and the man who was with him got a little bit impatient and asked what he was doing. The chess champion said, "Something about this painting bothers me. I want to study it for a while. You go ahead and have a wander around." When his friend came back to the chess master, he said, "You must locate the man who painted this picture. We must tell him that either he has to change the picture or change the title. I've determined there's something wrong with it." His friend says, "What's wrong with the painting?" The man replied, "It's titled Checkmate, but the title is wrong. The game is not over. The king has got one more move." Bless the Lord. Isn't that a great story? And the crowd that day saw Jesus breathe his last, and he did. His natural physical body died on the cross. His disciples were scattered in grief. The leaders of the Jewish and the Roman authorities were slightly relieved, if not more than slightly relieved, that their problem had been disposed of. But they failed to understand not only did the king have one more move, he was making a move that would change history forever. That he was about to be raised from the dead. And Steve read to us those verses about Jesus rising from the dead. And it makes no logical sense, does it? If you're sitting here this morning in 2023, that somebody would come back from the grave. It makes no sense whatsoever. Now, over the last 15 years, I have probably done hundreds, if not a thousand funerals, but I have never had any relative ring me up and say, you know that you buried Bill on Monday, well, on Thursday you turned up for breakfast. Nobody's ever done that. Nobody's ever said that to me. In all the time of all the funerals I have done, nobody has ever come back from the dead. But our faith differs from any other religion on the face of this earth because our Jesus is alive. The other leaders are dead and buried, and you can go to their tombs. You can go to Jesus' tomb, but you won't find him there because he's not there. He is risen. I like what Jay John says. Jay John says, if you're standing at a crossroads and you don't know which way to go, and at the crossroads stands a dead man and a live man, who are you going to ask for directions? It's true, isn't it? Jesus is alive this morning. And if you want direction from your life, it's no good seeking people who have no answers. You can come to Jesus who has all the answers. Because Jesus was no ordinary man. And if he were an ordinary man, he'd still be dead. But thanks be to God, he was the God-man, and he was raised from the dead, and he lives forevermore. He's no longer in the tomb. Death has been defeated. The scripture says this: if Christ had not been raised, then you in your faith is useless. You're still guilty of your sins. Something very special happened on that Easter weekend. Before Jesus was sacrificed for the sin of the people and for the sin of the world, sacrifice was commonplace among the Jews, and they used to go to the temple and they used to sacrifice animals. And once the animal had been sacrificed, it was not enough to kill it and for its blood to run. It had to be presented by the priest and put upon the altar. The blood had to be put upon the horns of the altar. I want to tell you today that our Jesus is incredible, because not only did he shed his blood for us, he rose from the dead and he presented his blood on the heavenly altar. And today there is a man in heaven who is crying grace and mercy over our lives. Amen. Incredible. No wonder, we said it on Good Friday, no wonder John the Baptist turned when he saw Jesus. He said, "Here's the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." And when the heaven was opened in the book of Revelation, they said they saw a lamb as it has been slain. Jesus' blood is on a proper altar in heaven, and it's crying mercy over you and me. Heaven is not some ethereal place where we float around on clouds like little angels. Heaven is a real place, there's a real altar, and the blood of Jesus Christ is upon that altar, and it forever has settled our debt with God. Praise his wonderful name. We declare it this morning. His blood cries mercy over us. Now, if you've ever been put in a will, somebody writes a will. I'm not in nobody's will. Nobody likes me enough to put me in a will. But anyway, but if you're in a will, you can't have it until they've died. It doesn't matter what they've left, whether they've left you a couple of shiny medals from the war, or whether they've left you a carriage clock, or whether they left you £200,000 or £300,000, that would be good, wouldn't it? Whatever they have left you, you cannot have until they die. And then once they die, the executor of the will comes along, and then he sorts out who's having what, and you get what was willed to you. I am so grateful this morning. Not only did Jesus die and leave me salvation by his precious blood, he rose from the dead to make sure I got it. Amen? Isn't that amazing? He saw the job through. Absolutely amazing. I love these verses here from the book of Romans. Who dares accuse who God has chosen for his own? Some of you need to understand this morning that once you come into a living relationship with Jesus Christ, he never accuses you of anything. He just sees the blood that was shed and mercy is cried over your life. For many of us, we get so agitated with ourselves, so upset that sometimes we sin and fall short of the glory of God. We all do that. But I want to tell you today, God is not accusing us. It's only the enemy that accuses us. And as we saw on Good Friday, he's been sorted out once and for all at the cross. Who then will condemn us? No one, for Christ Jesus died for us, and more than that, raised to life for us, and now is sitting in the place of honor at the right hand of God, and he's praying for us. Jesus rose from the dead, and he stands at the Father's side right now, and he's praying for you and for me. Who dares accuse us? Aren't you glad this morning for as much stupidity as we have done, for all the things that we have got wrong, for all the situations that we have messed up? God is not accusing us this morning because of the blood of Jesus Christ. Isn't that amazing? We wear robes of righteousness, and we often sing it that we do not deserve. We are clothed in something very special this morning. Jesus has made a way for us. And as we said on Good Friday, Jesus is our message. I want to say to you this morning, this church is not our message. You can come here and we'll love you and we'll make you a cup of tea after, and there's a hot cross bun and we've got some cookies that somebody's baked, which is great as well, isn't it? Thanks, Mel, for making cookies. It's all good in this church. They're trying to get me fatter than I already am, praise the Lord. But all sorts of stuff is going on, and Lord, the Lord wants to bless us. But the church is not our message. Being good and trying harder is not our message. Our message is this: Jesus Christ has died and has been raised to life again. Hallelujah. That's the message that we preach. We cannot help you. I'd love to be able to transform your life. I'd love to be able to sort things out for you. I'd love to be able to polish you up and make you better than you are. But I can't do any of those things. But there is one man who can. And his name is Jesus. Bless his wonderful name. Romans goes on to tell us, the Spirit who raised Jesus from the dead lives in you. Just as God raised Jesus Christ from the dead, he will give life to your mortal bodies by the same Spirit living within you. God comes into our lives by his Holy Spirit and makes us alive. I want you to notice something this morning. He says he gives this strength, his Spirit comes into our mortal bodies. We don't have to wait to get to heaven to experience God and to know his power and his love and his peace within our hearts. We can experience resurrection power this morning because Jesus is alive and he lives in us by his Holy Spirit, doesn't he? So it's not a fact that we are waiting. You know, there's a whole load of old songs about when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that can be. We can rejoice this morning because we are just as saved now as we will be when we stand before Jesus. We are secure in what he has done for us on the cross. He has saved our souls and we belong to him. And the Bible says nobody can pluck you out of his hand. Isn't that amazing? He's not going to let us go this morning. He loves us. We can experience today the divine power that lives in us by the risen Jesus. And you might be saying today, well, I don't understand that. I don't get that. Claire's granddad, who died some time ago, he died at 99. He was great. He's still walking. And one day he escaped from the nursing home and he walked back home. He was absolutely brilliant. But he was witnessing to a man at work and he used this verse. And that man actually got saved, and he was Cyril Baker, who was a preacher and a pastor of one of our churches. But he used this verse. He said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. And this morning online in the house, you may not understand what I am saying, that God can live on the inside of you. And it makes no logical sense, does it, at all? But here's what the Bible says, that if we believe in our heart and confess with our mouths, we shall be saved. Jesus wants to come on the inside of us this morning. Now, do you remember Jesus got approached by a religious man, Nicodemus? Nicodemus wanted some answers. You might be religious today, but doesn't mean to say you got any answers. And Nicodemus was a bit concerned about where he was going to go after he died, and he had a conversation with Jesus, and he came to Jesus at night because he was frightened what everybody else would think. It doesn't matter if you're scared about what everybody else thinks, just get to Jesus. And Jesus begins to talk to him, and he tells Nicodemus, you've got to be born again. And Nicodemus is trying to work it out because he's trying to work it out with his natural mind, which is always a bit of a problem, because what we believe in this church only comes by the Holy Spirit. So if you're trying to make it logical and natural, you're going to miss it by a million miles. So he's working it out as to what Jesus is trying to say. And he says this, I'm a big bloke, Jesus, and there's no way I'm getting back inside my mother's womb. That's what he was saying, wasn't he? He said, as try as you might, I'm not that small. I'm not going to get back in there. And Jesus said, you do not understand what I'm saying. And this is what he says. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to spirit. We've all been born of flesh this morning. As I said the other week, there's only one way into this earth. It's down the birth canal. Whoever you are, everybody comes the same way. And if you are going to receive life from God, there is only one way to receive it, and it is by the Holy Spirit. It's the Spirit of God that births life into you. The Bible says that we can pass from death to life by the power of the Holy Spirit that is in working within us. And some of you have been struggling, saying, how can I change? How can things get better? How can I know peace? You can't in a natural level, because flesh gives birth to flesh. We are all the same. And yet when the Holy Spirit comes, he transforms us on the inside. And today Jesus wants to come by his Holy Spirit and transform us. Now, people often ridicule us, don't they? And go, the trouble with you guys is you're just one of them born-again Christians. Do you know what the truth is? There ain't any other sort of Christians. Because that's what Jesus said, isn't it? He said, unless you're born again, you will never enter the kingdom of God. So you sit there and go, I believe the Bible, so does the devil. I'll get a church, so does the devil. I'm very good, so does the devil sometimes. He goes around like an angel of light. It's not the fact that we read the Bible or even obey the Bible or even come to church. There is only one way, and Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. It's by his Holy Spirit as he reveals Jesus to us, and our hearts become enlightened, and we know that we know that we know. The Bible says that his Spirit bears witness with our spirit, not with our bodies, but our spirit man, that we are now the children of God. How many of us can say this morning, I know that I belong to Jesus? And it's not a head knowledge. All sorts of stuff can be going on in your life. All sorts of disappointments and difficulties will be entering our world. But yet we know that Jesus lives in us and we belong to him. Isn't that amazing that Jesus loves us so much? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. We're just going to come right now, because I intended Good Friday and this morning just to preach the simple truth of the cross and the resurrection, because we are believing for lives to be transformed, not by coming to our church, but by coming to the foot of the cross and coming to know our Jesus. And you can only do that today by not me educating you, but by revelation. So I'm going to pray as Kelvin comes and just prays for me now. I'm going to pray that the Lord would speak to you this morning if you don't know Jesus. And maybe you're just a little bit away from him today. That again, his Holy Spirit would make himself real to you. He does never leaves us or forsakes us. Sometimes we walk away from him, but he never walks away from us, does he? So let's just pray, shall we? On this Easter Sunday morning, we have the privilege to know that Jesus not only died for us, he rose from the dead. And he placed his blood on the heavenly altar. And because of that, today we have peace with God. Not anything that we can do, but everything that he has done. The old hymn says, he took my sins and my sorrows. He made them his very own. He bore the burden to Calvary and suffered and died alone. How marvelous. How wonderful. And my song shall ever be. How marvelous. How wonderful. The Saviour died for me. And then he goes on to say, because once we know Jesus, we pass from life, from death to eternal life. He says, then with the ransomed in glory, his face I at last shall see. It'd be my joy through the ages to sing of his love for me. How marvellous. How wonderful. Father, this morning I just pray that for those that are watching online and for those in the house that have never engaged with you, Holy Spirit, would you reveal Jesus to people right now? Would you open their spiritual eyes, their spiritual ears? Would you soften their hearts right now? I pray, Jesus, that you would just make yourself real to them. For the first time, maybe, that they would see you for who you truly are, the Son of the living God, the one that died on the cross, the one that rose from the dead, the one that is the Saviour of all the world. So, Lord, I just pray that that anointing would fall in this place right now and that salvation would come in the name of Jesus. If you prayed that, then just say, God, come into my heart. Reveal yourself to me. I turn my life around and I give it over to you. It's not an easy believism. We're not asking you to join a church or put your hand up or wear a badge. We're just saying, if you love Jesus like he loves you, you're going to have to take up your cross and follow him. You have to turn around and give your life to him. And you're going to have to start to live the way that he wants you to do. bless the Lord. If you want to do that, we've got an Alpha course coming up. The Alpha course is not going to save you, but you'll learn a little bit more about Jesus, and Jesus is the one that transforms our lives. So Lord, I pray that your blessing would come right now upon us in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. The guys are going to come and lead us in a song. This is a fantastic song we're going to sing now. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. And then after, can we take the offering during this, please? Because we've got something to do after. Then after the song, we're going to drop the live stream. And Andy's going to come with some family stuff. Is that okay? It's great to be part of a family, isn't it? So you're on the live stream. You miss out because you're not here. So get here, all right? Come down from your tree, Zacchaeus. All right. And we'll see you soon. All right. Bless the Lord.
Amen. Bless the Lord. What a wonderful morning, amen. Let's stand if we're able. It's a wonderful song. Glorious day. It was a glorious day when Jesus arose. It's going to be a wonderful day when he returns. Amen. Amen. One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. Word became flesh and the light shined among us, his glory revealed. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Freely forever, one day he's coming. Oh, glorious day. Oh, glorious day. Bearing our sins, my Redeemer is he. Hands that heal nations stretched out on a tree and took the nails for me. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Carried, he buried my sins far away. Rising, he justified. Freely forever, one day he's coming. Oh, glorious day! Oh, glorious day! One day the grave could conceal him no longer. One day the stone rolled away from the door. Then he arose, oh, the death he had conquered. Now he's ascended, my Lord, evermore. Death could not hold him, the grave could not keep him from rising again. Living, save me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising.
my Savior Jesus is mine. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away. Rising he justified, freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away. Rising he justified,
oh glorious day.